Gout is the most common inflammatory arthritis worldwide, and is the only type of chronic arthritis that can be cured. It occurs in people who have high levels of uric acid or urate in their blood. Note that all healthy and normal individuals have uric acid in their blood. But if levels become too high, it may cause gout. Urate is formed when the body breaks down substances called purines. Most uric acid dissolves in blood, travels to the kidneys and leaves the body in urine. As it is clear, high levels of urate happens when your body produces too much uric acid, or when excretion of urate is decreased. Sometimes the real cause of hyperuricemia remains unknown. A high level of urate is called hyperuricemia. Hyperuricemia is diagnosed when urate concentration is above 7 mg per deciliter. At this level, uric acid becomes saturated, monosodium urate crystals begin to form and deposit within joints and soft tissues. This causes a lot of pain, swelling and inflammation in affected joints. During a gout attack, affected joints become extremely painful, tender, red, hot, and swollen. There are various medical and non-medical conditions that raise the risk of hyperuricemia and acute gouty arthritis. Age and gender are two important factors. Gout is usually considered as a male condition. It is about 4 times more common in men than women. It can affect men of any age, but the risk is greater as you get older. Thanks to the female sex hormone estrogen, women rarely develop gout before the arrival of menopause. That's because estrogen plays a protective role in gout by enhancing removal of uric acid by the kidneys. During reproductive years, estrogen levels are high enough to promote uric acid excretion. But after menopause, that usually happens in women between ages 45 to 55, ovaries make very little of estrogen. As the estrogen levels go down, the uric acid levels subsequently go up. So, menopause can increase the risk of gout in women. Regardless of gender, gout is particularly common in people older than 65 years old. Hereditary background is very important in gout. Studies demonstrate that gout strongly runs in families. Certain genes such as SLC2A9 and ABCG2 influence kidney function and increase the risk of developing gout. These genes may make the body more prone to accumulating uric acid and developing gout. Gout is much more common in overweight and obese population. The more you weigh, the more your pancreatic cells produce insulin, which makes it more difficult for kidneys to get rid of uric acid. This increases uric acid accumulation in blood and therefore puts you at higher risk of gout. Studies show that obese people are 4 times more likely to get gout than a person of normal weight. So, carrying extra pounds slows down your kidney's ability to remove uric acid. High blood pressure is one of the most common comorbidities of gout. High blood pressure, also known as hypertension, is independently associated with the risk of incident gout. Hypertension reduces kidney blood flow, increases kidney vascular resistance, and decreases excretion of urate from kidneys. All these changes lead to accumulation of urate in body and make hypertensive patients more prone to gout attacks. On the other hand, many antihypertensive drugs for treating hypertension, including water pills or diuretics like furosemide, hydrochlorothiazide, indapamide, metolazone and spironolactone, beta blockers like metoprolol, atenolol and carvedilol, and ACE inhibitors like captopril and enalapril, reduce urate excretion as well. In general, conditions that promote hardening and narrowing of arteries, that is so-called atherosclerosis, are connected with gout. Diabetes, chronic kidney disease, high lipid levels or hyperlipidemia, hypertension, and established cardiovascular disease such as history of heart attack or stroke, are some of these conditions which increase serum levels of uric acid and cause gouty arthritis. Finally, note that particular foods and drinks may trigger gout attacks. Alcoholic drinks, especially beer, high purine foods like liver, kidney and red meat, high fructose corn syrup such as soda, are common examples that must be avoided. Thanks for watching this video. If you are eager to enhance your health with practical tips, subscribe my channel and give a thumb up. Hope to be healthy and wealthy in your life.